So we often talk about creating posts to communicate with your customers. But do customers actually read these posts? Well, sometimes it's not just about reading the posts to find out what's happening, what's new with your business, but it's more about the fact it communicates by means of if they ask a question or if they're looking for something in particular, it's the keywords in the post that can sometimes bring your particular listing to the top of Google Maps. So think in terms of your writing not only for them to read it, but also to provide keywords for the people trying to find your business. So posts are a great way to get keywords into Google's indexing and to get customers to find your business. Today I'm going to reveal how I produce my posts. And if you produced a post 7 days ago, I realized I didn't really show you how I did it. So today I'm going to show you exactly an example of a post that I'm going to produce and put live. I'll show you the tools I use and the process I go through. We're going to find little corners, little niches in the areas around where your business is and see if it's untapped and see if there are people there searching for you and there's no competition. We're going to see if we can get some quick wins by just finding a few areas that are untapped in your particular business area. So we could call these location posts because you're being found for a particular location that someone's using. And this brings me to my first question for you, so comment below. Did you think that your local SEO is limited only to your town or your address? I think it's naturally the way most people think is the case, but of course you can expand beyond that. So what have you done? What areas have you covered? How have you expanded? Have you produced local posts that are using the names of the little cities, the suburbs, the towns that are near you? And have you had any success? Anything like that, put it down below. I'll be interested in reading about what you've done and I'll also comment back as well. Now, before I go into the section where I'm going to write a post together with you, so we're going to kind of work this out together. I just wanted to quote an Aesop fable that I read the other day. It says, "Men are born with two bags, one in front carrying neighbours' faults and one behind carrying their own faults." In other words, we can all see the faults of other people's posts. But sometimes we just need to look at our own and see what we can do to improve. So this is where I have that section questions to be honest with. So as we look at ourselves now, ask yourself these questions regarding your business and the posts in particular. What stops you publishing each week? Now we say weekly because every 7 days, the original post gets archived and it no longer really serves a purpose. Google wants at least once a week an update on what's happening with your business. Here's another question. Will you join me in a week's time? Because this is day 14, day 21. We're going to do another post together. And in that one, I've got some really cool tools that I'm not using in this one because I'm going to keep that for next week. But this week, we're just going to look at an example together. And here's a final question. Did you post 7 days ago when we did one together? Well, I realized I didn't give you much. I just said, do a post. And I gave you a few little tips. Today we're going to actually do it together now. So let's dive straight in and I'll show you how I write a post and I'm going to put it live with you too. So let me just take LaRue Window Cleaning Services, and if I just head down the page, you'll see that when we do add posts, this is where they show. So you'll notice that it's not been done for a few weeks, and you'll find as soon as you add a post, those next 7 days, you will get more traffic coming in. So we're going to add a couple more posts here. We'll certainly add one today on that section there. So that's what we're about to do. Notice products do come ahead of posts at the moment. These things do change, but keep an eye on that as well. So that's also something to bear in mind. So I'm going to go into the LaRue Window Cleaning. You notice there it's saying you need to create a post. That's a reminder if you haven't done one for 7 days. So you could just click on that. Or the same thing you can do is you can click on posts here. And what we're going to do, you could do a COVID-19 update, but you're quite limited on what you can do. You can't add images. It's not probably as useful if nothing's changed since the last time you updated. But what you want to do today is you want to add an update, and it's a what's new update. And you're just going to fill this information in, which we've done before, but this is where these post ideas, I'm going to give you some ideas as to what you can write about and how you can do that. And it comes down to area and then services. Those are the two things you're going to need. Let me now take you through what I mean when I say area. So if you go to Google Maps and do a search for your business, and it's true to say that the proximity is important to Google. So if a person's here and they're searching for a window cleaner, they're probably going to find you. The further away you go, the harder it is to find you. And that's where other competition and of course other window cleaners are based as well. So what we're going to do is just look at, is there a way in which we can niche in other areas that you haven't normally been found in? Okay, so what you need to do first of all is just come out of your area just a little. And as you come out, you notice the Southbourne obviously is the key area, so we'll put that down. So we know we've been already optimizing for Southbourne. We use Southbourne in most of the posts we've done. But have I used Wick? Now Wick's a little suburb near Southbourne. So there you go, so there's one that may be overlooked. So if someone's in Wick and they're searching for window cleaner that covers the Wick area, if no one's mentioned Wick, then how will Google know to put you in that particular search result? If you don't mention it in your post, Google can't rank you. Okay, so let's just pull it out a bit more. And we're looking again for the cities, the areas. So we've now got Tuckton. So let's put Tuckton in. And we're letting Google decide what it wants us to show ourselves in. Next, Christchurch. Now I'm going to make about five or six. So we've got Iford. Okay, next is pretty straightforward. Just go into your Google My Business and just go to your services. And now on your services, just write these down. So window cleaning. Okay, and so now what we're now going to do is we're now going to combine the two. So if you combine the service and the area, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 sixes are 36. You've got about 36 combinations now. So for the next 36 weeks, you've got 36 posts. So how does it work? Well, basically you could do window cleaning services. Let's just bring this across, shall we, for a moment. Put the word in on all of these. And you'll get the idea, you copy and paste that and do it again. So literally you're going to now do under Southbourne, under Wick, under Tuckton and so on. You'll get the idea. I'm not going to go any further. You'll get the idea because now it's just a case of taking that and put it there and there and there and there. And these are all your subjects. These are all going to be your keywords when you write the post. So now literally you'll take one of these and it'll be called window cleaning in Wick. And then you'll then explain how in your post. So let's just do that one. Window cleaning in Wick. So that's gonna be our first one. Window cleaning in Wick. And then what you can then do is you could go to your website or go to an area where you've already written some information. So what I'm going to do, so you can just look at rewriting a few things here. I mean, this was written a while ago. I'm going to copy and paste this and you might say, well, why would you want to reuse the same information? Surely that's not going to help Google, but actually it will, because what I'll do is I will now, instead of Bournemouth Window Cleaning Service, I'm going to put Wick. And it's fair to say he is a Wick window cleaning service in that area because it's just a half a mile up the road. And our services include, so for the Wick area, our services include. So call me now if you are in the Wick area. And Google's not particularly interested in double content on this. It's just interested in some of the, it's just going to pick up on some of these services. It's going to pick up on the fact it's in Wick. In fact, I might just take that out because I think it's right at the beginning. It's nice and clear anyway. And I might just then put it as the first subheading here. Let's just put it there instead. I think that looks better. And maybe we can put one more of those cleaning in Wick. There you go. And now it's just a case of adding a photo. Now, before you upload the photo, what I would just suggest you do as well is just go to Google Images. And I would just type in window cleaner in Wick and just see what comes up. So it's mainly window cleaning, glass. There's a nice bit of pole action there. You're just looking to see, to get some ideas, some inspiration. So whether it's a van, and you're checking just to see what Google does include. So vans can be included as a window cleaner, but certainly glass windows, some close-ups, someone at work, that's the type of thing. So you just want to see, have you got any of those types of photographs that you're going to add to? So I think that's quite a good one. It shows the window. It's in line with what we've just seen. So we'll use that one there. So that's now a case of, I think most people are calling. We've had quite a few calls come through, so we're going to click publish. There you go. And that's now accepted and published. And that is now designed. If I do a quick search for Wick, so you notice there, it's mentioned 5-6 times and it's not been mentioned anywhere else. So that's now optimizing for an area that, if you look at where LaRue Window Cleaning Services is, we could have easily overmissed it. And that's really a helpful tip that I want you to try with your business and with your areas, using this technique and then using the image idea as well, to see how you can bring all this together. And of course, that's just one. We've now got 36 or 35 others to do for the next 35 weeks. So I hope that's been really helpful to give you an example, a glimpse, an example of how to produce a post or a series of posts that's going to really tap into some unknown areas. But there is something else you need now just to add to that, and that's to be able to monitor it through insights. In fact, insights is like having the key to unlocking the door to more traffic. And so tomorrow, I'm going to show you how to use that insight key to unlock the door to huge traffic for your business. I'll see you on tomorrow's video.